Hello, welcome to the Monday, March 2nd, 2020 edition of the Sands and Storms on Us Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. A couple interesting diaries from this weekend. First, Xavier took a closer look at the Windows clipboard. What inspired him here was a vulnerability that was discussed last week, and I think I mentioned it here in the podcast as well, that on iOS, applications have access to the global clipboard. So if you're copying some text in one application, other applications may read that text from the clipboard. Well, in Windows, of course, we don't even expect kind of any separation like this. So very logical that, yes, any application can read the global clipboard. And what Xavier here did as an experiment is a little PowerShell script that will essentially monitor the clipboard every 0.1 seconds and then display whatever text it finds. A couple more sort of interesting items that he ran across here was virtual machines. If you do integrate the virtual machine with the host, then the virtual machine does have access to the host clipboard. That's sort of part of that copy-paste functionality into the clipboard. Of course, this could become a problem if you're using that virtual machine to analyze malware, but for malware analysis, you definitely want to keep those virtual machines isolated. Secondly, also iOS devices clipboard was visible on his machine. The trick here is iCloud. iCloud has this feature where it does help you synchronized clipboards. So again, that leads to content that you copied on the iPhone or iOS device to show up on your desktop. Doesn't really too much you can do about this now. Xavier mentions password managers. Password managers often have a feature where they have a browser plugin that integrates with your browser, so that avoids having to use copy-paste for your passwords. But sometimes, well, if the password manager doesn't quite understand the page, you may still be using copy-paste. I think I noticed that some password managers will sort of delete that content from the clipboard after a while, but well, they have to keep it in there for a few seconds at least. So Xavier's script that copies the content every 0.1 seconds, well, it would still get your password in this case. And we got a quick post by Guy about some scans for a Hazelcast vulnerability that he's seeing in his honeypots. And he hasn't really seen anything like that before. Haven't really checked in our data yet. Now, not sure how much Hazelcast is used, but it's one of those parts that you may find in other software, like apparently Citrix, the Xen mobile server, may be using it. It's not really clear which vulnerability is being attacked here. He found two possible candidates, one from 2018 and the second one that was more recent, and it was patched end of November 2019, but it could also be something new and different. And something I forgot to include last week, but Kevin Beaumont is reporting that he is seeing some scans for a recently patched Microsoft Exchange Server vulnerability that could be used to execute code as system. I think I pointed this one out as part of the sort of critical ones here that you should patch quickly in the last Microsoft patch Tuesday. This is CVE-2020-06-88. And if you're running Apache Tomcat, pay attention because you may be vulnerable to the Ghostcat vulnerability. This particular vulnerability does use the AJPD, Apache JServer protocol, that's typically listening on port 8009, and it does affect all current versions of Apache Tomcat. A patch was released last week, but there are already a number of proof of concept exploits available. This vulnerability does allow file read access to arbitrary files on the web server, so someone could read confidential configuration files, source code, and the like using this vulnerability. Certainly something you want to patch or mitigate rather quickly. Now, typically you don't have to have your Tomcat server listen on this port publicly, but then again, it all depends always on how you have things set up and what you're exactly using Tomcat for. Well, and that's it for today. So thanks again for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow.